Hello guys, welcome to our YouTube channel. So today you're going to be learning what adhesives are, the types of additive and materials and the chemicals. But first of all, I remember when I picked up a bottle of glue, I squeezed some onto the broken part and held the chair legs in place, trying to fix it. How many times have we broken something important and struggled to fix it? Glue is everywhere, but most of us don't stop to think, what exactly is glue? What makes it strong, and can we even make it ourselves? This tiny bottle of glue, it is holding things together, not just objects, but industrial furniture, electronics, construction, and even our daily lives. But how is it made? Yes. Stick with me, because by the end of this video, you will not only understand adhesive, but I will also teach you how to produce your own hot glue. And if you want a free ebook on hot glue production, comment hot glue and I'm going to send you the link to get yours. Now, what is adhesive? An adhesive is any substance that bonds surfaces together by force attachment. Yes, it is used in packaging, furniture, construction, textile, automotive, and even medical application. Let's look at the types of adhesive. One, natural adhesive. This adhesive is derived from plants and animal. Examples are starch glue, animal glue, and we have the casein glue from milk. So let's look at number two. We have the synthetic adhesive, which are chemically produced for strong bonding. Our number one example is hot glue, which is your EVA based, used for packaging, craft, and furnitures. Number two is epoxy resin, used for industrial and structural application. And then we have super glue, which are your cinnamon cartilage bonds. It bonds almost instantly. We all know what super glue are. Then we have our polyethylene adhesive, which we are conversant with, which are your waterproof, flexibly used in construction. Now, the third types of adhesive are your pressure-sensitive adhesives, which are the PSA. You can find them in tapes, stickers, and label. The fourth types of adhesive are your reactive adhesive. This require hot moisture or UV light for it to cure. Now, let's look at the materials used in chemical for the production of adhesives. We have the base polymer, the VA, polyethylene epoxy resin. We have the track fillers, which are your rosin ester, hydrocarbon resin. Then we have the plasticizers, which makes the adhesive flexible. Then we have the fillers, which are your talc, your calcium carbonate for volume. Then we have the curing agent, which are the hardening components. Now that you understand adhesive, it is time to get on. For today's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to produce your own hot glue, the same adhesive used in glue gum for packaging and crafts. So now, let's talk about the chemicals used for hot glue production process. I'm going to be listing the chemicals. Number one chemical is your EVA, ethylene vinyl acetate copolymer. We have the wax paraffin, which are your microcrystalline wax. We have the track filler resin, your rose ester hydrocarbon resin. We have the plasticizers, which are the PPG. We also have the antitoxtant or stabilizers, which are your BHT or your UV absorber. So now, I would have loved to explain the functions of these chemicals, but I don't want the video to be too long. Like I said, comment hot glue, and I'm going to send you the link for you to get the ebook. It is completely free, so you can read the functions of this chemical and also the production process. It's going to have the measurement on each of the required chemicals for you to use, and of course the step-by-step production process. But also, let's quickly look at the equipment needed for the production. Yes, because some of us are in a country where we can have access to these chemicals and of course access to the equipment needed for the production, and of course you can start right away to produce. And for those of us that are in countries where we cannot find the equipment, you can also use an alternative equipment, which is going to be explained in the ebook. So now, number one equipment is your melted tank, yes, which is the heat controller for the EV and the wax. Two is your mixing rector, yes, for uniformly blending. And of course, we have the cooling conveyor or cutter. This shapes the glue stickers. And then we have the packaging unit to seal and label for final product. These chemicals are for those of us that want to be going for the commercial production. We want to produce this glue and sell it out. Remember, it's a hot glue production process. And now let's look at the step-by-step production process. First step is the heating and the melting, which you have to heat the EVA and the wax in a temperature control rector for about 1 to 6, let's say about 160 to 180 centigrade, stirring continuously for about 30 minutes until fully melted. Now, the number two is adding of the track filler resin. You slowly add your track filler resin while stirring, maintaining steady heat about 140 centigrade for proper mixing. And then the third mixing process is adding your plasticizers and your antidotant, where you have to mix in your plasticizers to adjust flexibility, and then you add your antidotant to increase shelf life and prevent oxidation. Now we move over to the final mixing process, which is you have to stir at low heat, about 120 centigrade, for 10 minutes until smooth. Please take note, the reason you are seeing the mixing process with the 120 centigrade, 140 centigrade, is because we are mixing with a rector. You understand? And of course, if you are not going to be using, you don't have rector to go about the production process of this hot glue production, you can make use of your stainless steel and your gas. But you need to get the 120 centigrade. You have to start controlling your fire by reducing and increasing. And I'm going to explain all of that to you in the free ebook, because I don't want this video to be too long. You understand? So now we move over to the cooling and shaping. Yes, after the production, you have to pour into molds or extrude into long glue stickers. Yes, because it's a glue sticker, you understand? So pouring it into the mold and of course into a long glue stickers will enable it to cool down for 15 minutes before cutting into standard sizes. You understand? And then we now move over to the packaging and storage, where you have to wrap in moisture resistant plastic and store in a cool, dry place. This is just a brief explanation on how you can go about the production process, and of course have an idea the required chemicals you can use for this hot glue production process. Like I said, in the free ebook, you're going to study more about this hot glue production, you understand? And like I said, I'm giving it away for free. I know how much it's worth to have this particular knowledge, but I'm giving it out for free to encourage my subscribers and of course my students, you understand? So imagine you now have the ability, that's you have the knowledge and the ability to produce industrial quality glue. These skills can launch a business, save money on supplies, or even open doors to larger scales manufacturing. You understand? Because when you start small and you do your practical and you learn it, you can grow bigger. You understand? So it wasn't easy at first for me. I have to tell you, my first batch was too soft. The second one didn't stick well when I did my production years back. But with persistence and the right formulation, I cracked the code. And today I am sharing this knowledge with you. So you have to also do your practice and of course keep learning, and you're going to get your unique production process. If you found this tutorial valuable, hit the like button and subscribe for more expert tutorial. And don't forget, if you want the free ebook on hot glue production, comment hot glue and I'm going to send you the link where you're going to get the ebook completely for free. Thank you for watching and see you in our next video. Bye.